So what is CPI? So as we know till now, so CPI is a cloud-based integration platform offered by SAP. It's a middleware that is able to connect both on-premise and on-cloud system running SAP and non-SAP systems, softwares. So if in the diagram we can see, we have cloud platform integration in the middle, we have on-premise systems, and we have cloud solutions. So CPI sits between your cloud and on-premise system. Okay, so CPI is basically installed in the cloud. So it can access data from Ariba, Concur, SuccessFactors, Field, any SAP platform, and any third-party solution, and it can send that data to your on-premise solution or on-premise system. There can be a scenario where the whole organization is on cloud. So even CPI can help you with that. CPI can integrate that. Okay. So what are advantages? So it's a cloud-based technology, and as I mentioned earlier, it's subscription-based. So it is comparatively cheaper when we consider the licensing cost and everything. It provides a web-based modeling and monitoring. So we saw that we would be using WebID to develop our interfaces, and then we will be using the same WebID for monitoring and administration purpose. The another advantage would be it complements SAP PO. So by complements SAP PO, I mean it can work hand in hand with PO. So SAP CPI is not a replacement of PO as of now. So in many landscape, you can see that there can be a cloud solution which sends, which connects to SAP CPI. CPI connects to your on-premise PO, and PO would be in turn connecting to your ECC systems. Okay, so these two can work hand in hand. It's not necessary that if there is a PI or PO, then you need to, you cannot use CPI. Okay. Another advantage is it's user friendly, and it uses a modeling design pattern. So we'll see how we can design iFlows in this. We'll learn this when we are actually doing the integrations. The another advantage is it's open to partner for developing contents like APIs and connectivity adapters. So we have a marketplace for that, where the customers can create APIs, create the documentation, and upload it in the marketplace. And from marketplace, everybody can access those. And one of the another advantages would be it's cost effective in terms of maintenance. So as SAP, this is a platform as a service. We do not need to. Hello. There's some background noise. Okay. So it's cost effective in terms of maintenance. So when you say PI, we have to manage the infrastructure, we have to manage the network. So we have a network team, we have a basis team, then we have a hardware team, and then few more teams. So in here we just need a developer team, and we do not need anything else. So this is basically cost effective in terms of maintenance. It also, SAP also provides bug fixes and patches in its monthly update, so we do not need to take care of those things as well. Okay, so do we have any questions till now?
No, so you mentioned about CPI, PO. What's this PO?
So SAP PO is a process orchestration. It is an integration solution that was designed before SAP CPI. It's an on-premise solution wherein you can integrate your applications using the SAP applications using the SAP PO.
Okay, so it's on-premise. Okay.
Yes. So okay. This is basically a solution that is before CPI, before SAP moving it to cloud.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So currently, many organizations are using SAP PO as an integration platform.
But PI is also on-premise, or it's a cloud platform?
So PI is also on-premise, but SAP has stopped the support for PI, and most of the organizations are moving from PI to PO. So there might be a chance in the future that everybody would need to move from PO to CPI. So, but that's in future. So that's in SAP's hand. Okay. Any more question? Okay. So take that as a no. So let's do one thing. Let's just build a very simple interface in SAP CPI, so we would know what we would be working with in the upcoming sessions. Okay. So I'll just share my whole screen. So is my screen visible?
Yes.
Yes. Okay. So now what we will do is we will build a simple synchronous interface. Okay. What we would do is we would just add two numbers. Okay. And then we would increase the complexity in the next one. So for a synchronous interface, what we need is we will have three systems. Okay. So basic synchronous interface has three systems. Okay. One would be the sender system. Let's just name is this. Let's just name this as sender. Let's just name it receiver. Okay. And this would be our integration system. Okay. So when a sender sends a request to integration system, what integration does is it sends that request to receiver. The receiver will process that request, check if this is a synchronous one, and then it will send a response to the integration system. Okay. An integration system in turn would send the response back to the sender system. So a synchronous service is where a sender sends a request and it waits for a response. And an asynchronous would be a sender sends a request and does not wait for a response. Okay. So what we are going to do is we would be creating a synchronous service where we would be sending two numbers to CPI. So now currently we will not be using the backend system. We would just do all the processing in the CPI itself. Okay. We would just add those numbers and we would be sending back to the sender.